Let's say that we are not familiar with the credit score.csv dataset and that we would like to learn more about it. This is what the details and the visualize buttons are for, to give us more insights about the feature types, the data distribution, possible missing values or outliers, etc. When clicking on the details button, there is a new window that opens, which shows us some descriptive statistics about each one of our features. Driverless AI also automatically identifies the storage type, and if you wish, you can change the logical type of a particular feature by selecting the Auto Detect button from the Feature Props section and choosing a different column feature engineering type afterwards. We will stay with the default settings for this first project. Back on the Dataset Details tab, we can also scroll right to see all the features from the dataset. But if you have tens and hundreds of them, I would recommend using the search section underneath the dataset details title. For example, if I start typing the word credit to filter out the columns by name, there are 7 of them, among which the credit score column, our target. Also, on the top of each feature name, you can see an interactive graph that gives you a nice view on the column's distribution. So, right off the bat, we can observe that the column credit score, which is a string type or a categorical type, has only 2 unique values, and it contains around 70% of the applications labeled as good, whereas the rest of them, around 29%, are labeled as poor or bad. Let's remind ourselves of the use case. As a representative of an insurance company or a bank, we would definitely want to avoid giving loans to applications which have a bad credit score, because this will determine whether our business will work at a profit or a loss, mid and long term. As a data scientist, on the other hand, working for the same insurance company or bank, being able to accurately predict whether an application might have a good or a bad credit score is the goal. Hence, the need to have a highly qualitative and unbiased dataset, as well as good machine learning models that can be easily scaled up. If you want to visualize the content of the dataset, you also have the option Dataset Rows on the top left side of the screen. This button gives you a preview of the dataset exactly as it is presented in its raw format before being added to the driverless AI platform. As in our dataset, we have 100,000 applications or rows, on the bottom of the screen, we see that we are able to navigate through multiple pages, and here we are just visualizing the first 23 of them. When you are done visualizing the rows, you can click the button Dataset Overview from the top right side of the screen to come back to the Dataset Details page.